Cobalt is a mineral found in products we use every single day. Smartphones and electric car batteries require this mineral to work. Most of the world's supply of cobalt comes from the Democratic Republic of Congo. It is one of the poorest places in the world.
Workers here face dangerous conditions mining the valuable mineral. The hidden cost of cobalt mining, an article in the Washington Post, has photos that show just how dire this situation is. Todd Frankel is a financial reporter and wrote that article and joins us now. Todd, why is the cobalt mining industry using this type of labor? We've been covering the child labor being used. It's truly disturbing. Why this type of labor?
If the companies had a choice, they would not be using children and having dangerous conditions. The problem is that 60% of the world's cobalt comes from the Congo, which is essentially a failed state, a very poor country, as you pointed out. And so it's catch as you can out there. You just try and mine in any way you can. And they would love for this to be regulated and treated like a regular industry. But unfortunately, in the Congo, it's very hard to get control of these mines.
You know, one of the interesting points that's been made, Todd, as you know, is when we talk to companies about why they would allow this mineral that's been mined by children to be used in some of their devices and some of their products, they say, you know, banning this type of thing would not change conditions in the DRC. Have you found that as well, which is that, you know, it's a horrific story. It's terrible when you read about and see images of young children working in mines. But in many instances, because the DRC is a failed state, this is one level of economic activity that people, whether they're children or others, are able to survive.
Yeah, when I talk to the miners there, none of them want to lose their jobs or give up their jobs. They love their jobs. I mean, in a country like Congo, mining is one of the few decently paying jobs to be had there. And so they want to hold on to these jobs. Talking to the miners, what they also want, though, is to be treated fairly, to have decent wages, some safety, and they would love for their kids to not work in the mines. But that is the problem that the companies face as well. Is talking to Apple, you know, they talked about perhaps, you know, pulling out of Congo altogether, you know, not taking any cobalt from this country. But they realized that would hurt the country even more if they were to lose these jobs, which are incredibly important. So Apple has taken the task of trying to work with the companies to eradicate this on the ground. It's really difficult to do, but, you know, these jobs are really desired. And so they're trying to figure out some way to manage both these problems.
So then, you know, what is the answer? You know, we've received statements from a number of these companies saying that they really try to root out child labor in their sort of chain, their supply chain. But, you know, we've been talking, and that's something that's particularly difficult to do. And then, of course, there are other countries like China, other countries that are not as concerned about whether or not child labor is being used. So, you know, what's the remedy here?
It's really difficult. A lot of this, though, is that, you know, cobalt was used for years in different products and no one paid that much attention. But now that it's in our smartphones, in the electric vehicles, in these products that we pay a premium for, companies realize that consumers don't want any part of this. And that's where the pressure comes from, right? So we complain about, you know, child labor ending up helping create the batteries for our smartphones. Apple, Samsung, LG, they get upset and they put pressure on their suppliers. There is a remedy that's been tried with other minerals, the so-called conflict minerals of tin and gold in the Congo as well. And that's sort of a regulatory scheme where it's constantly audited and monitored. It's really difficult to do, and it only is partially successful, but it's a step that people are looking at to doing with cobalt as well.
And I guess the question, Todd, is if more Americans were aware of these issues, these sort of, you know, morally conflicted issues that go into not just the phones that we listen to. I mean, I've done stories on children being used in cocoa fields to get us, you know, quality chocolate in certain African countries. Mm-hmm. And I think if people were more aware of that, do you think that would change the way that these things are, whether it's mining or whether it's agricultural products, how they get into our hands?
No, I think awareness is a huge part of this, and that really does help. You know, it's a poverty problem. I mean, these parents I talk to, they don't want their kids working in these mines. The problem is that their school fees, schools cost money, and, you know, food costs money, and they sort of need their kids to work in there. And so the companies then are faced with this problem of how involved do they get on the ground? I mean, mostly mining operations, you know, Apple isn't a mining company, and so it needs to put pressure on the mining company itself and in its suppliers to take a larger role on the ground, You know, there's been talk of building schools for these children for paying higher wages, and it's such a very intractable, very difficult problem, and it's not one that companies are used to taking a role in, but it's one that I think consumers are demanding more and more.
Yeah, we're demanding it, but how many of us are going to be willing to give up our smartphone or whatever, you know what I mean?
I totally agree, and that is really the problem. But, you know, with your iPhone, again, you're paying so much for that, or your Tesla, you know, how much those cost. And these companies realize that, you know, push comes to shove, people do get upset about this. Mm. And they have these brands they spend a lot of money convincing are good and perfect and, you know, lots of advertising behind it, and this can sort of undo all of that. So I think there is an incentive there for companies to do better. But yeah, I mean, making the public care and keep on paying attention to it, you know, this is a continuing problem. That's the challenge.
All right.
Todd Frankel of the Washington Post. Thank you, Todd, so much. Really great reporting. Appreciate it.
Thank you.